J-Ray501 here. I'm in Dr. Koshonia's blog. And she's got some pretty interesting articles about the asteroid YU55. This post is to keep you informed and not to frighten you. Indeed, at this time of increasing global consciousness, the last emotion you want to have is fear. Let's see, I'm just going to go straight down to the facts. YU55 will travel between the Earth and the Moon. It will be at its closest on November 8th and 9th, which happens to be the same day the U.S. government emergency services are preparing for their very first national major emergency test. Asteroid YU55 is 400 meters in diameter. And at 11:23 p.m. on November 8th, I think this is Australian time. I don't know what GMT UT is. It'll be at its closest position to the Earth, and it will only be 0.00217 AU from the Earth. Then at 7:13 a.m. GMT UT, it will be only 0.0016 AU from the Moon. NASA also gives the figure for YU55 as 0.85 lunar distances from the Earth, and the Moon is from 356,400 kilometers to 406,700 kilometers from the Earth, depending on orbits. So, here is somebody from NASA. This is at the end of one of their articles. There's an awful lot of really good links in here. Although classified as a potentially hazardous object, 2005 YU poses no threat of an Earth collision over at least the next 100 years. However, this will be the closest approach to date by an object this large that we know about in advance, and an event of this type will not happen again until 2028, when asteroid 2001 WN5 will pass within 0.6 lunar distances. The trajectory figures can't be 100% accurate, and so it is definitely possible that the gravitational pull of the Earth on the asteroid could pull it off course and pull it onto the Earth somewhere. And this would happen early on November 9th, the very same day FEMA has chosen to test their emergency services. Well, they're also testing the tsunami. It's going to be a worldwide tsunami emergency service on the exact same day as well. The other even stronger possibility is that even though the gravity on the Moon is very weak, there is still some gravity. And so YU55 could be pulled off course by the Moon and crashed into the Moon's surface. After all, it will travel a little closer to the Moon than to the Earth. Now, I think I read that Mr. Hoagland said that it is going to crash into the Moon. Yet again, if we all hold our breath, I'm not going to read that. So, I'll put money, even though I'm not a betting person, that the November 9th U.S. National Emergency Test is being prepared just in case there is a genuine emergency on November 9th. What does it all mean? If YU55 hits the Moon, the impact will be incredible and extremely visible from the Earth. This impact could well be the blue star we are to see in the sky at the end of this age that the Hopi speak of. Then immediately afterwards, we could have the Hopis predicted 3 days of darkness as the fallout from the impact blocks out the sun for several days until it all settles down a bit. By contrast, if YU55 hits the Earth, let's hope it hits a landmass, even though if it hits the wrong part of the land, hundreds of or even millions of people would be killed. However, if it hits the ocean, then it will cause a gigantic tsunami affecting so many more people in so many more places. Let's see. Our moon. The Earth's moon is the largest moon relative to the size of its planet, our Earth, than any other full planet's moon in the solar system. It is overall fifth largest moon. So why have we got such a large moon? It is said in some of the ancient texts that there was a time that Earth had no moon. And if you go back in time, that would make logical sense. And so maybe the time has come for us not to have a moon once again. But what a terrible thought. Our moon not only affects the tides and oceans and to a degree our climate, but it also affects our emotions, our thoughts, our moods, and so forth. Yes, our moon has an effect on us, physically, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. Anyone who's pulled a night shift is well aware of the fact that people do strange things when there is a full moon. So if we had no moon, there are many who suggest that the Earth could become a far more peaceful, calm, and more loving and balanced place on which to live. But what an awful cost. Just remember that there are always many ways to look at one situation. Okay, so this is a gentleman who posted something. He used to work for NASA at the Goddard Space Observation Center, located in Greenbelt, Maryland, for 18 years. He was working December 29, 2005, when a colleague of Robert McMillan from the Space Watch program called our private hotline about the information and trajectory path of YU55. They didn't think much of it, and so 2 years went by, and then the staff began to study the object and its trajectory path. Along with several objects, we tried to keep track, but what the general public does not realize, it's hard to find objects orbiting in space. Earlier this year, we had several government officials from DOD start retrieving data from our servers in that observatory sector. Shortly after, the federal government began cutting NASA's federal grant budget. As far as I know of now, NASA is no longer tracking YU-55 and has been deemed to a private organization. How do I know this information? Because I was laid off July 2nd. I do not believe YU-55 will hit Earth, but I will tell you that NASA never releases precise information on the near-Earth objects observed. The general public is left in the dark, and the federal government has intervened 3 times since my career. Okay, so I'm going to go into Get a Kit. This link is also provided in these articles. This is a FEMA. It's called Ready. And there are little instructional videos, or you can just go down this list. Basic emergency supply kits. Things that you should also think about. And also there are videos for pets, disabled people, elderly people, and then here's making a plan, which, I have only recently been doing myself. I think this is, definitely gotta get together with neighbors, friends, family, anybody that you know that you're close with. We need to come together here. We need to help each other out. Okay, and then there's also something, be informed. They do suggest, you know, having special alert radio programs, you know, battery held. So, you know, I'm just putting this out because I started to do a little research and then realized there really was an awful lot of information out there regarding this YU-55. So um, FEMA test and now the Pacific Tsunami Preparedness Exercise. I just think that's really interesting. And then somebody asked, well, why would they be having these tests on these dates if we're going to get slammed on the 9th? Somebody said, well, NASA never tells the truth, right? So, so what's really going on? I now tend to be more convinced than ever that something extremely life-changing for many is possible around the 8th and the 11th. Whether this will be physically life-changing or just spiritually life-changing, only time will tell. NASA never releases precise information. So, it's also said, and I do want to make a point, that the Mayan Indians, as well as Rinchope, a Buddhist monk, will be traveling across the United States starting in New York, and their ending date is 11-11-11, and they will be in Los Angeles with the 13 crystal skulls that are supposedly supposed to raise our consciousness as they go across the United States and make stops, and supposed to open us up, like it says here. Maybe the Stargate or the date the gateway portal will open, the date we reach the null zone or singularity point, the date on which something major could have happened that will trigger the actual start of the new global spiritual consciousness of higher order thinking, practical spirituality, and ethics-based love. Okay, so, I just wanted to put this out there, and if I, you know, find more hardcore evidence, I will put that out there as well. Be prepared, be safe, and get down to basics. You know, there's nothing more important in this moment, or any moment, really. But there's nothing more important than I can think of right now than being at peace with your life, with everything that's going on. And it's all about love right now. It's all about loving yourself, loving your family, loving your friends, and telling them so. Getting right with the world. I think just doing that is going to be a huge conscious shift. And anyway, that's just my belief. So, be safe, be smart, be loving, and be prepared. God bless.